Now, considering a radiation from electromagnetic horn, consider a sectorial horn flared out in the plane of electromagnetic field with a flare angle 2 psi as shown in the figure. In order to understand the radiation from the electromagnetic horn, let us consider a sectorial horn flared out in the plane of electrical field with a flare angle 2 psi as shown in the figure, and this is the sectorial electromagnetic horn in the E plane with the various parameters, that is the length, height and the angles theta 1 and angle psi and all other parameters. Now, if the flare angle is small, then there are wavefronts that is equal to so that of the apertures. That is, if the flare angle is very small, so then there are, if the flare angle is very small, then the area of the wavefront is equal to that of the apertures. And this condition gives the best operation of the horn. That is, if you want to get the best output from the horn antenna, then the flare angle must be as small as possible. Then the area of the wavefront is equal to that of the apertures. Then the total field at a distant point is the combination of the field due to number of Huygens sources over the wavefront. So that is, at the observation point or at the point P where you are measuring the signal strength, there the total field at that particular distant point is the combination of or the sum of the field due to number of Huygens sources over the wavefronts. And this field will be constant over the aperture in the y directions, and this field will be varying in the x direction. the field due to the Huygens forces will be given by E equal to E0 dx dy divided 2 lambda r into 1 plus cos theta 1. But for distant point, theta 1 equal to 1, therefore cos theta is equal to 1. Hence, we can write this equation as E equal to E0 dx dy, so divided by 2 lambda r. Then, the strength of the Huygens forces over the aperture will be given by E equal to E0y into cos of pi x1 divided by a. Hence, the total field at a distant point along the x-axis is E equal to minus b by 2 to plus b by 2, and minus E equal to an integration E equal to double integration, where the limits are changing from minus b by 2 to plus b by 2 and minus a by 2 to plus a by 2, E0y divided lambda r cos of pi x1 divided by a into dx1 dy1. And this you can write it as, because E0y and lambda r is constant, we will take it outside. Then E equal to E0y divided by lambda r, and integration from minus b by 2 to plus b by 2 and minus a by 2 to plus a by 2 cos of pi x1 by a dx1 into dy1. And from the geometry, z1 is given by l cos theta 1 minus l cos phi. So this value equal to b square by 8l minus y1 square divided by 2l. Then E equal to E0y divided by lambda r, integration from minus a by 2 to plus a by 2 cos of pi x1 divided by a into dx1, and mode value of minus b by 2 to plus b by 2 e to the power of minus j beta epsilon into dy1. And solving for the integrals, E equal to 4a E0y divided by pi lambda r, and integration from 0 to b by 2 e to the power of minus j beta epsilon into dy1, where this epsilon equal to y1 square divided by 2l. Hence, this we can write it as e is equal to 4 pi e 0 y divided by 4 lambda r 0 to b by 2. In place of this epsilon, we will substituting y1 square by 2l. But beta into y1 square divided by 2l equal to pi by 2 into v square. Hence, v equal to y1 into root of 2 by lambda l. That is, dv equal to root of 2 divided by lambda l into dv1. Then, using the standard Fresnel integral, we can write this equation as e square equal to 2l divided by lambda into 2a e0y divided by lambda r whole square into c square into b divided by root of 2 lambda l plus a square into b divided by 2 lambda. Let us solve few problems on horn antenna. The first problem is determine the length P of the horn, the H plane aperture and the flare angles theta E and the theta H in the E plane and H plane respectively of a pyramidal horn for which E plane aperture is 10 lambda. The horn is fed with a rectangular waveguide with TE10 mode. Let delta is equal to 0.2 lambda in the E plane and 0.375 lambda in the H plane. Calculate the bandwidth and the directivity. In the given problem, the pyramidal type of the horn antenna is given and some parameters are given in the problem and you have to calculate the bandwidth and the directivity. Thank you. For the E plane, delta is equal to 0.2 lambda is given. Therefore, the required length of the horn is P is equal to A square divided by A delta. This is equal to AE divided by A delta. And AE is given in the problem as 10 lambda divided by 8 into delta is given, that is 0.2 lambda. If you substitute the values, then you will get 62.5 degrees. Then the flare angle in the E plane is equal to 2 tan inverse of A divided by 2P. So this is equal to 2 tan inverse of AE divided by 2P. So this is equal to 2 tan inverse of AE is given as 10 lambda. 2 into P is calculated, that is 62.5 lambda. So this is equal to 9.147. Then the flare angle in the H plane is theta is equal to 2 cos inverse of P divided by P plus delta. And P already you have calculated here as 62.5. And delta is given in the problem is 0.375. If you substitute it, I will get the value is equal to 12.521 degrees. The next parameter to be calculated is the H plane aperture. H is equal to 2P tan of theta H by 2. This is equal to P value already calculated 62.5 lambda into tan of theta H already calculated. It's equal to 12.251 divided by 2. The value is going to be 13.7129 lambda. Then the half power beam width in the E plane and the half power beam width in the H plane we are supposed to calculate. The half power beam width in the E plane is calculated from the equation 56 lambda divided by AE. So the 56 lambda divided by AE is given in the problem, that is 10 lambda. If you substitute it, lambda and lambda will go, and 56 divided by 10 going to be 5.6. And then half power beam width in the H plane equal to 67 lambda divided by H. And AH value is already calculated. This is equal to 13.7129 lambda. If you substitute it, lambda and lambda will go. Then you will get the value equal to 4.8859. Once you calculate half power beam width, in both the E plane and H plane. The next parameter to be calculated is directivity. And the directivity is generally calculated in decibels. So therefore, directivity in dB is equal to 10 log 10 of 7.5 into AP divided by lambda square, where AP is the physical aperture, and the physical aperture is calculated from the equation theta E into theta H. Substitute in this equation, that is 7.5 into AE into AH divided by lambda square. And AE value is given in the problem 10 lambda. AH value you calculated as 13.7129. If you substitute it, so then we will get the value as 30.1219 dB. So this is the directivity of the antenna which is asked in the problem. Now let us take one more problem. The dimension of an aperture of pyramidal type of horn antennas are 10 into 5 centimeters, and it is operated at 6 GHz frequency, and you have to find the beam width, power gain, thank you. the given frequency is 6 gigahertz, and you will write in terms of hertz, 6 into 10 to the power of 9 hertz, and the wavelength can be calculated from the basic equation of communication, that is lambda is equal to c by f, c is equal to, that is velocity of light equal to 3 into 10 to the power of 8 divided by 6 into 10 to the power of 9, so the value is going to be 0.05 meters. And for the pyramidal type of the hertz, you have to calculate the half power beamwidth both in the E plane and the H plane. And the half power beamwidth in the E plane is calculated from the equation 56 into lambda divided by AE. So this is equal to 56 degree into a lambda is calculated as 0.05 meters divided by AE. So in the given problem, the size of the horn antenna is given as 10 into 5 centimeters. So these values you are converting into meters. So the 10 centimeters we are converting into meters. Therefore, it is 10 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meters. So this is equal to 28 degrees you will get. Similarly, the half power beamwidth in the H plane is equal to 67 degree into lambda divided by H. 67 degree into lambda is 0.05. AH is, in the given problem, 5 centimeters is given, convert into meters. This is 5 into 10 to the power of minus 2. So the value is equal to 9. Then the power gain is given by Gp is equal to 4.5 into Ap divided by lambda square. This is equal to 4.5. So whatever this Ap is there, it is a physical aperture. The physical aperture is nothing but the size of the antenna. So the size of the antenna is given as 10 into 5 centimeters. So we will have to convert into meters. So therefore 10 into 10 to the power of minus 2 into 5 into 10 to the power of minus 2. Lambda already it is calculated as 0.05. Substitute here, you will get the value equal to 9. Once you get the gain, you get the gain in the decibels. Gain in dB is equal to 10 log 10 of Gp. And this is equal to 10 log 10 of Gp calculated as 9. Substitute 9 here, you will get the value is equal to 9.5424 is the power gain. Then you have to calculate the directivity. Directivity is calculated from the equation 7.5 into Ap divided by lambda square. 7.5, AP is nothing but AE into AH. This AE and AH values 10 into 5 centimeters will convert into meters. So divided by lambda will substitute here, the value is equal to 15. Then the directivity you can calculate in dBs, that is decibels. So this is equal to 10 log 10 of D. So D value I calculated as 15. Substitute here, you will get a value equal to 11.761. This is how you can solve the problems related to the horn antenna. Now consider another problem. Find the power gain in dBs of a square horn antenna with an aperture size of 8.5 lambda. For square horn antenna, AE and AH values are same because both the sides are same, that is equal to 8.5 lambda. Hence, power gain of the square horn is GP is equal to 4.5 AP divided by lambda square. So, this is equal to 4.5. AP is nothing but AE into AH. And this is equal to 4.5, substitute the values of AE and AH, that is equal to 8.5 lambda. Then this is equal to 4.5 into 8.5 lambda whole square divided by lambda squares. And this is equal to 325.125. Now the power gain in dB is equal to 10 log 10 of D. So this is equal to 10 log 10 of 325.125. So this is equal to 25.1205.